So who in their right mind is going to buy an electric zero turn mower in the middle of a Minnesota winter? That would be me, folks. I've been looking at electric zero-turn mowers pretty much for a year or so now, and I kind of settled on the one I got. It's a Ryobi 48-volt, all-electric. And the reason that I've been looking for an electric mower is mostly because we produce all of the electricity that we use with our solar panels, and one of the goals I have is to try and eliminate as much fossil fuel burning as possible. So mowing is a considerable activity that I do with my tractor, so if I can keep the hours lower on the tractor and use electricity that we're already making here instead of buying diesel fuel, that's a win-win as far as I'm concerned. I found this mower at eBay. Been looking at them for a long time. Home Depot sells them. Home Depot, last time I looked at their price, they wanted about $4,800 for this model. I paid about $3,000 for it, including shipping from eBay. Obviously a end of the year closeout kind of deal, but that's fine. It has still has 0 hours on it, so I'm pretty happy with that. So let's take a little time and put this thing together. So here's the new mower. It is a zero turn, all electric, from Ryobi. Let's give you a little walk around here. I just took delivery. I needed the tractor with the forks to pick it up at the end of the driveway. Everything looks intact so far. Here's what came packaged with the mower. Nice seat, it looks like. We got 3 keys with it. Operational directional levers. A manual, a little pack of tools, a whole bunch of stickers. This was labeled a tow bar, a couple of bolts. Not sure what this is yet, maybe a mulcher for the mower deck, and the charging unit with a handle. Mower uncrated here, not uncrated, but okay, here's the mower with it without its packaging. And do a little walk around here. You can see it has some lights. Where the seat will go. Got a nice cup holder. A couple fancy boxes here for tools or whatnot. See the model number there. It was very well packaged. I don't see any dents, scrapes, or broken parts anywhere as of yet. So now I need to do some assembly. We'll see how that goes. Here's the charge port for the mower. Here's the control panel for the mower. We have a port right here so you can charge your cell phone or whatever other device you might need to. Here's for low speed cut, which controls the speed of the blades. Low speed drive controls how fast the mower will go when you push the handles all the way forward or backward. Light control. This red button turns the mowers on or off. It's like a PTO switch. And then your key control right here for off, on, or auxiliary. So when you turn the key on, it tells you with those beeps that there's no weight in the seat. It also tells you that right here, 100% power, and the mower has 0.7 hours on it right now. The mower came from Georgia, so obviously they didn't drive it here. All right, I've assembled the mower. Now I'm going to attempt to drive it off the metal pallet. Wish me luck. Okay, what's wrong with this picture? I always gotta do a couple of stupid things. See these straps here? They secure the mower to the frame. And they're doing their job. I didn't cut them. As you can see here, I finally got the zero-turn mower off of the pallet frame it came on. I had to lift it off with the tractor, but it was okay. Charged up the battery, I fixed the seat switch, and we're good to go. I can't wait till I can do some mowing. I'll be doing a full review of this mower once it's time to start mowing grass. I appreciate you guys coming along with me today, and we'll see you soon. Thanks for watching.